Beattie, Beattie, what the hell are you doing wandering on here? The show's on. What is it? Is that the milk you returned, Milky Barrett?
Yeah, bring back the wee drop I got off you last week.
You got no milk from me last week, dear. I was making a recording last week.
Indeed I did. I got the line of a wee drop of milk off you last week. Mean it well, because that was the night my Willie was down with a cool, and I give him hot milk going to bed.
Good as your Willie bad again. I wish you'd feed that man's malnutrition. The man's skin and bone, he's skin and bone, he's skin and bone.
Well, anyway, I mind saying, tell him, Willie, I says, isn't it a good job I had milk to give you? Hey, do you know he was that bad, my Willie was, that his temperature was away 200 and something?
Your head's cut for God's sake. Nobody's temperature could be 200. You must have put the barometer on it by mistake. Nobody's temperature could be 200, they'd be dead.
Isn't that what the doctor said? Willie, he says, according to your temperature, he says, not only are you dead, but you're in hell.
Living in your house, the same thing.
Take him to the hospital and all the convulsions and everything.
Where?
They put him under sedition.
What? You're making a long playing record. It's not sedition in the hospital, it's sedation.
No sedition. It was the Mater Hospital.
The Mater.
The Mater.
The Mater. Something was the matter with him. You took him to the Mater. I say, it's a wonder you let him go to the Mater, like with your point of view. Do you know what I mean now?
They never asked me. They walked straight into the house and marched up the stairs.
Who, the ambulance man? Yes. Got into your house without warning you. God, I'm sure the place was bogan. Into Willie's room and nothing emptied or anything. Oh, desperate.
Them long stretcher things.
Yes.
God, I was affronted, afraid no pajamas or nothing on.
Sure, God, he hasn't got pajamas. The milkman told me he sleeps in your old knickers.
Well, anyway, they took him down the stairs and shoved him into the ambulance and shut the door on the way they went.
Oh, poor Willie. Oh, poor Willie. Is he all right again?
Oh, he's grand now. But here, wish I knew where I got this milk. No, I don't know where. Oh, I know where I got it now. I went up those stairs at the back yonder, and in the wee room on the right, and here, dear, there was a lady sitting there drinking a cup of tea.
Yes, oh, they're all ladies. Oh, they're all ladies in this place. Even the recording man's a lady. Oh, yes.
Well, anyway, I seen this bottle of milk sitting half full, and it was sitting on the floor beside the sink. So I looked at her and I lifted the bottle and I says, I wonder would you mind, I says, if I had the Lena alone of this?
Yes.
Oh, that's all right, she says, but don't forget to bring it back.
Yes.
So I lifted the bottle and walked out. That's where I got it. God, I'm glad I minded.
Was this in the theatre? The group theatre? Down there and up the wee stairs?
Yeah.
And into the room? Mm. My God, that's the clean woman's room. They're very particular in this theatre. You know, the place is cleaned after every time it's used, it's cleaned and disinfected. But it wasn't done last week because we're at a telly. The clean woman says to me, she was sitting in her wee room, she says, and she'd mixed up Jesus fluid in a milk bottle. And she said, I had left it beside my sink, she said, ready to disinfect the theatre. And she said, some old doll, she says, come in with curling pins on, says, can I have the lane of this, and walked out and never brought it back again. Do you know what you have done?
No.
You have give Willie hot Jesus fluid. It's no wonder he had convulsions. That would kill a bloody horse.
Oh, I'm awful sorry. I'd better go and explain to that lady. But you know, I wouldn't like her to think that my Willie drunk her Jesus fluid on purpose.
I say.